This is Channel 2 News, coverage you can count on.
We could have done this a month ago, we wouldn't be in this predicament.
A Washoe County resident has filed a lawsuit against the county, saying that they violated state law with the appointments of committees regarding WC ballot question one. Campaign 2016 tops Channel 2 News at 5:30. Of course, WC1 would increase Washoe County sales tax by more than a half of a percentage point or a percentage to build 15 new schools and allow repairs on older ones. Good evening, I'm Landon Miller.
I'm Kristen Remington. Thanks for keeping it here tonight. Now, state law says the Board of Commissioners has to appoint two committees with three members each to prepare the arguments for and against ballot questions. That's something that Jeff Church says never happened on WC1. Paul Nelson joins us live in the newsroom with more on this lawsuit. Paul, why is Church suing Washoe County over this ballot question?
Well, most of it's over the process of it, Kristen. Church says he and one other person were appointed to the opposition committee, while four were appointed to the one in favor of the question. The process started back in April, but he says none of them were approved by the county commissioners.
Voters will have plenty of decisions to make come November 8th, including WC1. If approved, Washoe County sales tax would increase by 0.54%. The reason is to raise more than $780 million for the school district's capital needs in the next decade. But that question could be challenged in court by Jeff Church.
The registrar, without any approval from the Board of County Commissioners, appointed four people to the pro committee, two people to my committee. So right away, you know, it's like two heads are better than one, four are better than two.
Church says that puts the opposition at a disadvantage and that each committee should have no more than three people. The lawsuit was filed last Tuesday, 9 weeks before Election Day.
I'm hoping that in the next few days they can come to some kind of resolution. We can get this done. We can have a committee that's approved by the board meet, get her done in a couple of days, and get it on the ballot.
Supporters of WC1 say the lawsuit has no basis and that the question should be presented as is.
You know, it's frivolous litigation that's a distraction from the important task at hand, and that's building new schools to alleviate overcrowding and making repairs to our existing infrastructure.
While Church agrees overcrowding is a big issue in our schools, he says one of his biggest problems with the question is that the tax does not sunset once the goals are met.
It's a poorly worded, never-ending bait-and-switch ballot measure.
The repair needs of physical structures don't sunset, and so the revenue streams to fix them shouldn't sunset either. And so we're looking for a permanent solution so that we don't get into this mess again.
Now, the county says the registrar does have the authority to appoint committee members pursuant to a resolution approved back in March. Another issue for Church is his rebuttal to the proponent's argument will not be on the sample ballots. Washoe County says that's because the two committee members couldn't come to an agreement, saying, quote, "The stalemate persisted throughout several extensions of deadlines. Ultimately, the registrar's looming deadlines for translation and printing forced the decision to move forward without a rebuttal to the proponent's arguments." Covering campaign 2016, Paul Nelson, Channel 2 News.